Welcome to the InfoGov Hot Seat Vodcast, featuring candid interviews with practitioners, consultants, and solution providers on hot topics in the information governance industry. Here's your host, Jim Merrifield.
Hello and welcome to the InfoGov Hot Seat. I'm your host, Jim Merrifield, and with me today is Jordan Uytterhagen at Cadence Solutions. Welcome, Jordan.
Thanks, Jim. Glad to be here.
Yeah, thanks for taking the time to sit in the hot seat and allow us to ask you a few questions. Let's kick it off here. Can you give me a brief introduction of yourself, your current role, and one fun fact about yourself? Don't forget the fun fact.
All right. I'm Jordan Uytterhagen, founder and CEO of Cadence Solutions. We're a Microsoft systems integrator firm that focuses on Purview, SharePoint Online, and SharePoint Premium. A fun fact about myself that's fairly current is in about 30 days, I'm going to trap my two kids and my wife in a motorhome and drive 10,000 miles across America on a once-in-a-lifetime trip. So.
Awesome. That's great. Any particular sites that you want to see? I don't want to spoil it for the wife and kids, but anything.
We're all on board. We're going to about 15, 16 different cities down the West Coast, across through the Grand Canyon, Dallas, down to Disney World, of course, up to New York, and then probably over to see Mammoth Caves and all the way back home. So it's going to be an adventure. It's a testament to can a family get along for 46 days and can Cadence operate without Jordan for 46 days as well. So
yeah, we'll have to see. We'll have to see what happens. Oh, that's awesome. Enjoy it. So listen, I know you've been a busy person, going around different conferences and things. And I met you, earlier this month at ARMA Canada Conference in Calgary. Just wanted to ask you a few questions about the conference. How was your experience?
That's great. Yeah, I've been attending ARMA Canada for probably coming up on a decade. I do the conference circuit in spring, and then there's quite a few to go to. So it was the fourth of four on the circuit this year. And the thing I like about it the most is it's actually a community vibe at that one. It's not a salesy conference. It's not a software vendor announcing new functionality and, you know, trying to pipe you up or pump you up to buy something. It's very grassroots and sales oriented, or community oriented instead of sales oriented. The benefit I see is like they end up being very regional as well. So it was in Calgary. There were a lot of, you know, Saskatchewan folks, Alberta and British Columbia. A few made the trip like you, Jim. I'm from out of town, but it's good to see those folks every year.
Yeah, for sure. I was pumped that my wife and I got to explore Banff a little bit. We didn't see any grizzly bears, but we saw a few deer. But we'll have
be
to.
Be a good thing.
Yeah, probably, right? Because I forgot my bear spray. So was there a particular session or a networking event that you especially enjoyed at the conference this year?
The networking event at ARMA Canada has got to be the trivia night. So that's iconic. I was pestering Trevor Banks about that online prior to the conference saying, are we doing this again? Because, you know, post-COVID, kind of getting this thing launched. And him and Courtney did a really good job hosting that. So for the folks that don't know, there's a trivia night during the ARMA Canada conference. It's a bit of a fundraiser as well for some scholarships for folks in the industry. And it's usually well attended. You host it at like a brew pub or a bar of some sort. Have a great time for a couple hours. Answer some InfoGov questions and a lot of other ones that may be a little harder in terms of geographic or other kind of Jeopardy style questions. And you get this really unique award, this plaque of a wooden beaver. It's serious, but also a gag gift. And maybe Jim, you have a photo of that to throw up on this later. But it's hilarious. So. It's a really good event.
Yeah, I'm going to have to dig up the photo. It was a wonderful experience. It was my first time at Trivia at ARMA Canada, but it was definitely an awesome experience for sure. How about the education? Did you learn anything new at the event?
I did appreciate the AI presentations. So, you know, AI is maybe becoming a bit nauseating with it being at every keynote. I appreciated the one that kind of dug deeper. From Amy, which is one of the machine learning institutes here in Alberta, that dug into the how it operates as opposed to the concept of why I need to use it. I thought that was really, you know, as a former technical guy, I really, you know, paid attention in that one and appreciated that. The success stories from, you know, records managers that have had a project, you know, launch properly, and also some of the horror stories you hear. I always like to hear those as well in the sessions, because everyone can learn from those, and we're glad that they're shared both positively and negatively. We don't just want, you know, rainbows and sunshine every time. We want to actually, you know, hear some of the battle scars and the wounds that happened along the way that we can learn from as an industry.
Yeah, for sure. I think the keynote that you were alluding to, I thought initially it was going to be a little more technical than, you know, a little over the audience's head. But I tell you, after talking to some of the attendees in the sessions, people learned quite a bit from that session.
Yeah, and to pile on that one, Jim, I think that's not expected at the ARMA Canada Conference, like that kind of session. So kudos to the planning committee there to bring in that type of topic. We feature a lot of keynotes that are, you know, they can kind of end up being vanilla or the same year over year, but that one was definitely, those two stood out a lot.
Yeah, no, thanks for sharing that. So, I mean, the conference was great. Obviously looking forward to next year's event. And, but in more exciting news, I saw last week hit the news that ARMA and Cadence entered into a new exciting partnership. Can you talk about that a bit?
Yeah, absolutely. We've been a big ARMA supporter for a number of years, prior board member and a chapter as well. And kind of got working with the ARMA executives, looking at extending our training offering, which focuses specifically on Microsoft Purview in records management, e-discovery, and data loss prevention. And I got into a conversation with them saying this has been really popular for us. We get a lot of ARMA members joining the training. It's 2 to 3 days, depends which course you join, virtual training, which is hands-on to learn Purview from a records, e-discovery, or DLE angle. That's now offered through ARMA. There's an official communication that went out the week of May 21st. And it can be, you know, I guess, added to your cart, so to speak, from the ARMA side of things. And there's a discount as well on it. So everybody kind of wins. Really excited to get kind of going on that with ARMA.
Yeah, I think we're all excited. Now, who would attend those? I know you mentioned ARMA members, but is there a specific skill set that maybe you're targeting for this training course?
Yeah, we get, it's kind of interesting when we get the attendees. So we get your, you know, traditional records manager that's, you know, now skilling up and getting into Purview. And that's even prior to purchase. So if they're looking at moving from an E3 to E5 and, you know, opening the box and getting more functionality, they'll take the training to kind of learn what they should focus on as they embark on a deployment. We also get quite a few, you know, IT system administrators, and that blending of, you know, security and records in the Purview platform has lent to that audience attending the training. So they're like, I'd like to know enough to carry the conversation as an IT administrator with the records and the legal and the risk folks, because Purview essentially starts with IT, and then we try to get it unlocked and, you know, portions of it granted access to the records folks. And another kind of interesting thing with the training is we get a lot of like groups from the same organization in the same session. So mm-hmm. Companies aren't just sending one person. They'll send, I'm going to send 2 IT administrators, 2 InfoGov people, and then kind of circle back after, which I found really interesting. We didn't expect that in terms of the attendees. And the value they get out of it's great. And it's a hands-on environment, which is really why we launched it. We saw a gap in training, even for sending my folks to, where none of it was hands-on. It was all theoretical, or someone's clicking through a PowerPoint, which only gets you so far. We set up a lab, give you a login, give you access to the lab after the session's over. And you can actually build your own labels, run your own dispositions, really have a bit of a playground in the sandbox so you can learn. My style's always been that way. If you give me a book, I'll read it. I'll forget 90% of it right after I'm done. If you give me something to play with, I'm going to remember how I made it work or didn't make it work or solve that problem along.
No, that's exciting. And what company these days doesn't use some aspect of Microsoft? So very excited.
Maybe Google. That's probably it. So,
yeah, Google. That'd be interesting, right? Google might use Microsoft. That'd be an interesting concept to explore. Well, listen, Jordan, thanks so much for answering a few of these questions. Are any final thoughts you want to leave the audience with that we didn't discuss?
Looking forward to seeing anybody at the ARMA InfoCon, InfoNext, or the next ARMA Canada Conference, because we'll be at all of them. Big supporters of the community. And if you want to reach out to me, I'm on LinkedIn. If you could spell my last name, you'll find me there. So I'm the only one. So.
Yeah, likewise. Look forward to seeing you. Jordan's always posting. Check out his post recently last week. It might scare the heck out of you. on about Copilot and ChatGPT. I won't say anything more, but yeah, check out his post. It was very interesting. A lot of conversation there. But again, Jordan, thanks so much for spending some time with us on the hot seat. Enjoy your trip. If I don't see you before then, well deserved. And of course, if you want to be a guest like Jordan on the hot seat, all you got to do is go to our website, infogovhotseat.com, submit your information. We'll get you on the schedule. So thank you so much and enjoy the rest of your day.
Sounds good. Thanks, Joe.
Thank you for listening to another episode of the InfoGov Hot Seat. Follow us on Spotify, YouTube, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, and LinkedIn. Check out our main website at infogovhotseat.com to view our latest episodes and much more.